Hey guys, hope you will be doing awesomely well. In this series, we will be discussing some very high-yielding stuffs regarding to your microbiology. These things are not only very important, but are also very volatile. So my main focus will be to bring these important things into your long-term memory so that you don't forget them when you need them, that is during your examination. Now this is our first slide. Don't get worried by seeing all these stuffs because I'll be making it very simpler by showing you diagrams and explaining you how you will identify them. So first slide is organism and their culture appearance. So coagulase positive staphylococcus shows golden yellow colonies. Coagulase negative staphylococcus shows white colony or oil paint colony. Now these are over. Glossy colonies for avirulent streptococci. Spidery or sunray, very beautiful appearance by the actinomyces. Salmonella shows a typical jet black colony. H. influenza is very famous for satellitism phenomena, and that I will explain you. School of fish or rail track by H. dukri, Haemophilus dukri. Fish in stream or swarm of gnats by Vibrio cholerae. You need to differentiate both of them. School of fish and fish in stream, they both resemble similar, they both resembles but are different thing. So you need to know both of them. H. dukri, school of fish, fish in stream, Vibrio cholerae. Stormy fermentation is a characteristic feature of Clostridium perfringens. Bordetella shows many different types of things like thumbprint appearance, aluminium paint, bisected pearl, mercury drop. So all of them belongs to Bordetella. Fried egg colonies, you must be liking fried eggs, but here it belongs to Mycoplasma. So fried egg colony appearance for Mycoplasma. Drottmann or carom coin, you will see like caroms over the culture media for pneumococci. Carom coin for pneumococci. Fish in stream, I have already told Vibrio cholerae. Now we will simplify it by gaining a picture. The memory of them. So satellitism is a phenomena shown by Haemophilus dukri. What happens is Haemophilus dukri is not able to grow on 5% sheep blood agar. So when we put a pure streak of Staphylococcus aureus in this blood agar, what happens is this Staphylococcus aureus gives factor 5, that is NAD, to the blood agar. Now H. influenzae has both factor 5 and factor 10. So it can grow near this Staphylococcus stream because this blood agar was having factor 10 but not factor 5, and Staphylococcus gave this factor 5 to the blood agar, and so we see colonies of Haemophilus influenzae near this Staphylococcus, and the phenomena is known as satellitism. I hope you will not forget this. Now jet black colonies typical of Salmonella. School of fish, as I have been already telling you, or rail track is for H. dukri. So remember this. You can Google more pictures for it. Fish in a stream or swarm of gnats for Vibrio cholerae. You can see coma-like organisms showing darting mobility for Vibrio cholerae. Fried egg, typical appearance of Mycoplasma. Trotman's carom coin colonies for pneumococci. You can see in this real picture of colony, you can see coin-like structures particular or typical of pneumococci. This is a beautiful sun ray appearance for actinomyces. Here you can see Clostridium perfringens doing stormy fermentation. Now this is thumbprint appearance of Bordetella. You can see small Bordetella organism in shape of thumbprint. So thumbprint, aluminium paint, bisected pearl, mercury drops, all for Bordetella. Now I will come to another very, very important slide. Why I am saying it important, because you know, or you see, if you have given the exam, the NEETPG and the JIPMA, they are now asking very long questions and you have very less time. So as to solve these long questions, what you need to do is you need to focus on certain words to face the diagnosis. And those words, among them, if it belongs to microbiology, they can be the motility of organism. And from that only you can face the diagnosis. That's why this slide is very important. So if they have mentioned darting mobility, it will belong to Vibrio cholerae or Campylobacter. Listeria shows tumbling mobility. Mycoplasma shows gliding, while Clostridia moves by stately movements. Borrelia has lashing movements. Okay. Trichomonas shows twitching movements. Trypanema pallidum shows corkscrew movement, and Fusobacterium shows spinning movement. So these were some typical movements of organism you need to remember. The third important slides, it is important because already four questions have been asked in your NEETPG. I will name them, I will make you understand, remember them first, and then I will mention others also, because now others are also important, because once they have asked, they can ask related things or related questions to it also. Now the four questions which have been asked were Oraya fever or Carrion's disease by Bartonella baciliformis, Ghoul fever or epidemic typhus by Rickettsia prowazekii, Wheel's disease by Leptospira, and Haverhill or rat bite fever by Streptobacillus muniliformis. Sudoku is a new term or new disease which you should know is caused by Spirillum minus. Cat scratch, very famous cat scratch, is caused by Bartonella henslei. Brazilian or purpuric fever by H. aegypticus. Undulant or Malta fever is equally important by Brucella. Shanghai fever by Pseudomonas. So I'll be making these type of high yielding stuffs, and our main focus will be to make you understand and put these important high yielding volatile things directly into your permanent memory, so that you don't forget these when you need those. So guys, please enroll in this.